Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Hollow Knight with me, Penza Hybrid. I hope you enjoyed the last episode where I sang for you for, like, what seemed to be an eternity as we tried to venture through the White Palace, which is apparently the Super Meat Boy area of the game that I'm hoping is optional, even though I clearly know it is optional because I can go fight the last boss anytime I want. But now I've gone too deep. We are in way too deep, as Sun41 said. And this part has confused me. See, what I love about this puzzle, what I love about this trap section, is the fact that they took so many tropes from these types of games, and what I'm saying by these types of games is Super Meat Boy and I Want to Be the Guy, and they've turned them on their head, because those games did not have a parallax background. So what they did was they made this background impossible to stage. So rather than being like, okay, well, I'm simply just going to walk to the center of that window, but as you see, the window moves as you move. I cannot do it while it's going down. It's unreliable, and I'm stupid. But yeah, they changed the way that it works. Also, those fucking sprites in the middle of the foreground are not helping me when they appear. So it's like, hey, I heard you'd like to see where you move. How would you like to not see where you move? I also have hiccups right now, which is fantastic. I will do this. Why would you do what I just did? See, that one should hit me. I don't understand this one. Team Cherry, if you're watching, explain this. Explain why those other ones hit me, but this one didn't. It's cutting through my fucking eye. Nonsense, Poopy Pants. I dashed too early. I was preemptive dashing. It was like a role-playing game, except this time preemptive was a bad decision. Life is built on bad decisions that eventually turn into good decisions. Right now I'm making bad decisions become good decisions. For Christ's sake. He died for your sins. The least we can do is give him some entertainment in the form of me dying over and over again. Oh, what is this nonsense? What is this nonsense? Oh, I see your game here. Oh my... Please, thank you. Oh my Jesus. That's too low. It's just the actual worst thing I've ever seen in my life. That's too high. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. You deserve better treatment than that. So I'm just gonna tell you straight up. If I cannot beat this place in the next 25 minutes, this area will not be done. I will be leaving. And I will go fight the last boss. And we will win the game. Because I need some form of victory that is not this. As much as I would love to beat this, I will not turn this series into something like this. I will not turn it into Penta tries to do the same damn rooms over and over again. Episode after episode. Because that's just not entertainment that I want to put out. You may think that it is, but I tell you, you are wrong. And the worst part is I know I can do it. And the worst part is I'm sure it gets worse. I just happen to have stumbled across the one part of the puzzle that screws me over the most. Because it's spatial timing, and I cannot handle spatial timing with a parallax background because I can't rely on cheesing it with my mental math of counting steps and stuff like that. See, like, that was as easy as it's ever been. I think we're right there, right on the money. Oh my sweet baby Jesus, I hope you love me. I hope you worship all your love inside. I will. Falcon! I had a feeling. Oh, and it's even worse when the buttons stick. That's too low. I adore the design of this area, but I hate everything about it. So that is something to say about the game. Why does the jump button not work half the time? I don't understand. Why can't you just work? It's a simple button. I'm hopping along a wall. That's all I'm doing. But yet, you seem to have the most difficult time actually functioning. I know there's something over there, but I'm sure there's something of more importance over here, such as a switch. Your light, magnificent and true. Oh, there's a thing up there. Oh, there's a thing up there. I want to touch everything. See, that time the double jump was so delayed. I don't mean to be rude, but fuck, man. It's been an ongoing issue for the entire playthrough. And for the people that are like, oh, it's just your control stick going, man. It's not just a control stick. For starters, A, and the most prominent point of everything, point A, is that it's not just the control stick. It's A, X, B, left trigger, the control stick, and the D-pad. Explain to me how a three-month-old controller, I believe it's 3 months old, has all of those buttons work, and also explain to me, if you would kindly, how it's not just me. I want to go over there. I want to go over there. Excuse me? I don't know how that works, but it did, I guess. Was this a shortcut? It was a fucking shortcut the whole time. Excuse you, sir. I should not have used all that soul because there's a bench right back here. And you're goddamn right I'm salty. That's... yeah. You got me. Good job, sir. Nice deduction you did there. Area, give me a triple jump or something? What the hell? Also, is there no map man? Is Cornifer not a person here? Oh my. Okay, we know now. We know to stand right here. Done. Good. Moving on. I knew there was going to be a saw there. Okay, what is our plan going up? I need to get on this wall. Thorns, it actually startled me. For some reason, it actually startled me. Also, I find it unbearably rude that you would start me at the fucking bottom when clearly there was a platform for me to stand down there. I double jumped into the blade because he floats. Arrgh! Okay, okay, calm down. We're fine. Moving on. It's not like it's the end of the world or anything. It's not like, you know, my entire sanity is balanced on the fact that I can't complete a single fucking puzzle in a bit. Double jump? Would you get out the wall? Oh my Christ. He doesn't fucking jump, okay? I'm not going to lose my mind over the fact... I'm just... Whatever. Fuck everybody. Fuck you watching. Fuck everybody who made this game. I just want everyone to know that it is your job to make sure that controls work. That's all I'm gonna say. I'm not gonna be apologetic about the fact that I'm salty because the controls don't work half the time. And I realize it's not half the time, Penta. You're such a fucking lunatic. Why are you saying that they work half the time when they clearly work most of the time? Like right there, perfect example. All it takes is a double jump to get over the blade, but for some reason, guy don't want to do it. He just decided he didn't feel like doing it. He wanted to get hurt. And you wanna know what? Fuck you. Flawless jumps right there, though. Just fucking jump, please. Thank you. It's the one important button in this entire game. There's a blade right above me. There's two blades right above me. Okay, so I get my plan here. Well, I mean, obviously I want to go over there, but right now I want to go over here. This just seems brutal because I don't know what's actually happening underneath me. Oh, I see you there. Be a shortcut. Alright, let's see what I gotta do here. This seems incredibly fucking stupid. Where is my time to jump here? Right here. This is insanity. I mean, I love it. And I'm salty. There's no doubt about that. But it is insanity. And it's absolutely gorgeous level design. Where's my time to jump here? I think my time to jump here is right... No, it's not there. You're gonna make me go in between them? What kind of madman would make me go in between them? I mean, are these things I can stand on? They are. Okay. But I can't see what's over this way. And I'm sure there's more blades, because that's the way this game works, man. Wait a second. Okay, don't be excited yet. You can't see my face right now, but you cannot understand how distraught I look at the fact that I came in here and heard more blades. That was not enough to heal me, boy. Your light, magnificent, and true. Yeah, thank you. You're fantastic people. Oh my god. I know what I have to do. I have to synchronize them to go up and down at the same time. So it's every other one. So now I go down. And I gotta... What? Okay, alright. I get it. I see your game here. So now what is the plan here? I think just honestly dropping straight down is the plan. Seems like it was the right choice. We will wait. Thank you. I'm glad you're waiting. It makes me honestly the happiest person you could ever imagine in your life. So now there's a thing down here that I can hit. That does something, I'm assuming. It's like the damn Temple of Time, man. I can go up again, but I will bench first. And before anybody starts commenting, dude, he's just a salty, salty dad. It ruins the fun of the... No, it doesn't. For starters, A, saltiness or rage. I guess this is technically rage because it's going on and on and on. Is a lot of gamers' way of... moving past certain things in game. Wait a second. Wait. Thank you. What did you not understand about hitting the guy? Oh my fucking Christ. Raging is a perfectly reasonable way to vent frustrations and say things that aren't necessarily true, but it is a gamer's way. They have moved now, which is great. It's good to know that they've officially gone in a different place that they were. I don't understand what my choice then was. So they move based on where I hit them. I'm getting your mechanic now, Mr. Friend. Hold on. Also, I understand this. I don't know why that was so hard for me to parse together. Oh, it's a bench. Okay. I don't want to go down there. What would be the point? Yep, that was a decision I made. And I will forever live with the consequences of it! I wish I understood how this one worked. Oh my god. I see what I have to do. Fuck. But you had to give me the world's tiniest ledge to do it on? Are you kidding me? Are you actually kidding me right now with the world's tiniest ledge to do this shit? It's good to know there's a part of the game that actually involves you using your up look and down look. Yeah, I don't fucking understand. To go up as soon as he doesn't fucking jump. I swear to Christ. Yeah. One word review. Controls. Three word review. Controls must work. Five word review. Controls must work, you assholes. I pushed the joke further, but I think the point is clear. How did that even work? I should have, Baba. I'm safe as long as I'm not. I get it. I accomplished the understanding of that simple situation. They gave me enough room to slide on the wall. I do love this area. Don't let it be misunderstood. I love the idea that there's an area that basically forces you to use all the abilities you've gained throughout the game. I love that. What I hate is the fact that sometimes controls don't work the way that you think they should. And for that, there's a delightful part of the game that's like, oh, well, you're gonna force me to use all these abilities that I've gained throughout the game. But you see, when the control for that ability does not work some of the times in a perilous area such as this, you're gonna get a little frustrated. Understandably so. Oh, that timing is gonna be brutal as fuck. See, like, right there, if my double jump didn't work there, I would have been screwed. I also mistimed that. That was on me. Oh, you fucking asshole. Start me at the bottom. I wish for one measly fucking second that you would start me in an area that wasn't quite such a... quite a dick move. I have to go through it all again. All of it. Every single second of it. And for the people that were here, you know, 22 minutes ago or 20 minutes ago when I first mentioned this, left trigger didn't work there. Tried to cancel it, didn't work. Awesome. People were here 20 minutes ago that heard me say, if I can't beat this by the end of this episode, that we're gonna not do this area. I hope you realize that I wasn't kidding. I do hope you understand and have, you know, heard the part of my voice that's, you know, this is fantastic. The part of my voice that was very, very, very serious about that. That was not sarcasm. That was not Penta raging and being all, you know, a salty fucking shithead. That was me saying, hey, if we don't get this within a half hour, we're just gonna leave and fight the last boss. Because I was not expecting Super Meat Boy to be the last two episodes of the game. As much as I love this area, it's just not something that I want to complete in a Let's Play format because of the fact that I'm doing this the wrong way. Because of the fact that this is not entertaining. It does not allow me to be entertaining. It's not entertaining to you, and if you are finding this entertaining, you're a sick masochist, and I hope you get kicked in the shin. Which many of you probably appreciate the fact that this is taking me to a blood pressure level that I'm not physically capable of reaching on most occasions. And that's fine, because people like watching people have a hard time with things. That's why rage gaming is a thing! It is a thing, because people enjoy seeing people have rough times with shit. I do myself. I am guilty of it. That was, basically backpedaling right there. Look at this, the control fucking locked up. Christ. Good fucking Christ. It's such a good game. And if there was an area to be designed in a video game like this that accentuates the fact that controls mean literally everything in a platformer, this is the area that accentuates that the utmost. just doesn't work sometimes. It just doesn't work. I wish I could argue against the fact that it just doesn't fucking work sometimes. I really wish. And maybe I'm taking it a bit too far, further than most other people that I've seen play the game, but when people I, you know play the game and they're like, look at that, look at it, just doesn't work. It just doesn't work. People I see play the game and they're like, oh yeah, there was a lot of minor control issues, you know, with the buttons not working sometimes, and no, I just moved past it. And I'm like, yeah, well, I don't have the level-headedness that you obviously do, because when I get shit like this, where I'm stuck on a goddamn, in a Let's Play format, stuck on a goddamn room for 30 minutes, and I have to call that the episode, that's just not the thing for me. And the thing is, if this wasn't in a Let's Play, I'd be perfectly fine. But I get more frustrated at the fact that I have to make you guys watch me do this shit over and over and over again. And that's just sadly not entertaining to me. Also, be a shortcut. This area has taught me one thing. This is going to be a shortcut. This area has taught me nothing. I want you guys to understand the area has taught me nothing. I learned nothing from that. Yeah. Delayed double jump. And it's no fault of the devs. It's the fault of the QC team who was responsible for checking this shit. That's whose fault it is. The devs did nothing wrong, unless they were the QC team, in which case, hire a QC team, guys! Hire people to test! Hire people to be able to tell you that, hey, so just wanted to let you know that there are parts in the game where, you know, your controls working 50% of the time severely dampened the experience. That just seems so fucking stupid, and I think I see a way around it, but at the same time, I wish I would have seen that way around it earlier. I jumped into the saw because I'm a fucking idiot. We bow boys, counting down the time before I quit. I can't jump quick enough off that wall. Fuck, that's not the right way. Did you guys see that bug there? That I died and apparently the screen got all dim and I... Oh wait, I just can't fucking leave? Are you kidding me? I have to backtrack through all this shit to fucking leave? Oh, this just isn't a real thing, is it? This is just a sick joke you're playing on me, right? You wouldn't actually trap your player in an area like this, would you? Is there an exit fucking ridiculous area button? Is there a please get me the fuck out of this area button? Because I don't think you understand the severity of what this episode has devolved into. It has devolved into me basically saying to myself, I will just quit. Thank you for not making me backtrack through literally everything in the world. Let's find out if this is actually an exit. It is an exit. Good day, sir. So I get it now. This used to actually be the palace grounds. Well, I mean, it is the palace grounds because it actually literally says it's the palace grounds. But this is like the door, and this is his faded memories of when the palace was once standing here. Gotcha. So you know what? Here's what's gonna happen. That's just not the way I want to go. Oh God, can you just fucking work, please? Beyond frustrating. It's so frustrating to the point that I'm like beyond. I'm actually past bitching about it right now. I've grown tired of bitching about it. As you've probably grown tired of me bitching about it. The irony is real. The funny part about that is that's actually not irony. That's the real joke. Oh, and woe is me, the viewer, who's, oh, I had to bear listening to this guy get all frustrated at a game. Ah! You know what? You've seen people get worse with games. You've seen people get more frustrated at games. You've seen people get more ragey. I'm not breaking controllers. I'm not throwing things. I'm just pissed. So you know what? Take your high horse and kill that fucking horse. And get over it. As the saying is. That area. Screw everything about it. Let's go find out what's in the Black Egg Tower. Because I want to know what's in there. I would like, very much so, I would like episode 40 to be the end. So unless this guy is unparalleled difficulty, I think we have a chance to make this the end. So we need, fragile strength is broken, so we're gonna have you. You. Honestly, you and you. I think that's a decent setup for right now. However, I have no idea what this boss fight entails. So I could be totally wrong. I have been wrong before, and I'm okay with it. Don't let my salty and my rageness ruin the fact that I am unbelievably excited for this. Oh shit. Oh shit. Let's go in the egg. That's never been a good idea. What? What is this Billie Jean nonsense? Boom, 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 boom. Hold on. Bam, 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 bam. She was more like a beauty queen. Sorry, I just, you had to. You can't resist. I'm at the end of my wits here, Mr. Hello, good friend. Vessel, though bound, you shall know the state of the world. Hollownest will be whole again. Completion percentage viewable in inventory. ...92%! Wow, that's a lot higher than I was expecting. Holy shit, 92%! We're only missing 8% of the game. What the fuck does the love key do, though? If anybody knows what the love key does, feel free to spoil it. We are about to finish the game up. I do not care about spoilers. Let me know what that thing does. Also, if you would, let me know what you get if you do deliver that flower. Because I will eventually do it, but I'm curious. 92%, that's way higher than I was expecting. Alright, let's see what happens. I'm expecting something epic, like a cutscene. I hope that it's not just walk in, fight a boss. I hope there's some kind of cutscene or lore or something or a conversation. Holy shit. Dude, he is... Wait, that's the Hollow Knight! Wait, what?! Wait. The Hollow Knight was inside the egg that they worshipped that was sealed? Wait a second. Am I missing something here? The Hollow Knight used to be like their favored warrior. What did that mantle say? It said he sacrificed himself. I get it. The infection was taken over the world. He sacrificed himself by enclosing himself in a shell with the infection, hoping that it wouldn't escape, and then it eventually did? Wait, what? And then he got so infected that he turned evil, and so the dreamers had to seal him in permanently? What? I might be wrong. It's just gonna go right into boss fight, isn't it? It totally is. There's not gonna be any conversation. The Hollow Knight. And I'm honestly, not even a joke here, I'm hoping I, like, literally just unbelievably kick his ass. I would love to one-shot this dude. Like, there is no doubt in my mind that one-shotting this dude would make me feel like a damn champion. I knew he was gonna hit me there. Oh, he is disgusting now. What is the lore of him doing that shit? Okay. I promise, next time he's down... Okay, except for that time, obviously. But the next time he's down... I want a dream nail. He's immune to it or something. Okay. I dashed, but... cool. Did I just win? Don't you credits me. And now I'm gonna be locked up with it. Holy shit! And it's gonna get sealed again. My mouth has been open for, like, way too long. Oh my God. I mean, braggadocious attitude aside from one-shotting the final boss. Holy shit. What a fucking ending! I'm like all tensed up and, you know, butt clenched. Wow! I was not expecting a bad ending! I know there's multiple endings, but I was not expecting the bad ending to be that ending. That was dark. Extra special thanks to 2,158 backers and Kickstarter. Thank you very much, guys, for making this game happen. Thank you, Team Cherry, for making this game absolutely fantastic. Congratulations, well done on achieving this great feat. You persevered and triumphed. We hope you enjoyed yourself in the world of Hollow Knight. We'll meet again soon on the road ahead, Team Cherry. Oh my God, game completion. 92%. 32 hours, 24 minutes, and 56 seconds. Steel? What? What? Steel soul mode? No shade, no reviving, permadeath. Fuck. That's gonna be brutal. That I didn't even know about. And I still believe all my achievements are bugged. Yeah, my achievements are still bugged. I haven't earned a single achievement in this game, pretty much. What is the 8% I'm missing? Like, I'm trying to think of things that I didn't get done. I mean, the White Palace. The Flower Quest. There's no way that of all the content in this game, all 32 hours, that those two things are 8% of the game. There's no way. There's gotta be more. There's gotta be more I missed. There's gotta be... Oh, wait, I didn't get all the caterpillars. Okay, I didn't get all the caterpillars. I didn't get all the charms. Okay, I'm seeing a way that there could be 8% left. Holy shit. What a brilliant, miraculous, gorgeous, beautiful, heart-wrenching, dark, macabre, salt-festy, rage-inducing, blood pressure peaking, calm, soothing, serene, artistic adventure through Hollow Knight. And thank you, not only thank Team Cherry, not only thank the backers for the Kickstarter campaign, but thank you, everybody who's been with me on this journey. And thanks to everybody who is watching in the future after this video has gone live on the internet and will remain there for the rest of eternity. thank you for being here with this journey. I hope you had an absolute blast like I did. It may have seemed... There might have been some dark times, there might have been some very up times. Mostly the Colosseum of Fools was probably like the peak of as good as I've ever felt. As salty as I was in there, like, oh, he shouldn't have hit me, stuff like that. But the Colosseum of Fools was like unexpected. The Hive was unexpected. It was so much of this game. 92%, 32 hours. And there was probably 20% of this game that's required. And I would even venture to guess less than that. And so the question is, basically, can I speedrun this game? Can I, now that I know all I have to do is fight the Dreamers and then go fight the Hollow Knight, how fast can I beat this game? And the real question is, are they going to remain, is the Hollow Knight going to remain as difficult as he was for me? Even though I beat him in the first try, he was still a tough boss. Will he remain that hard at a level 1 nail? That's the question I have to ask. But thank you so much for joining me on this journey. Episode 40. I was not expecting this Let's Play to be 40 episodes long. I was not expecting it to be 32 and a half hours long. We got 92% of the game done. As far as I'm concerned, that's a success in itself. Also, please let me know in the comments below. Excuse me. I'm talking too fast. I'm losing my breath. Let me know in the comments below. What were some of your favorite moments in the adventure? What were some of your favorite moments with me through this adventure in this Let's Play? What were some of your favorite holy shit moments? What were some of your favorite magical moments? What were some of your favorite moments to laugh at me being an idiot? Just let me know all kinds of shit down in the comments. Also, please, of course, spoil the shit out of me. Let me know the 8% that I missed. I want to know, what does the love key do? What do I get for as a reward for doing the flower quest? I'm sure it's another charm, one of the ones I'm missing. What the hell is at the end of the White Palace? Please let me know that, because I might actually go back in my own time off cast or off camera and do it myself, because if I'm not recording, I don't get as salty. When I'm recording, I get salty and ragey because I feel like I'm wasting your time being bad at things. But I think that's enough of a monologue. I think that's enough of a monologue. This was an incredible journey. This was an incredible journey through Hollow Knight that will stick with me for a very long time and is going to need some serious competition to not be my game of the year this year. Here we are in April, and I might already have my game of the year. This was sincerely one of the best games I've played in a long time, and thank you Team Cherry for providing me the opportunity to play this game. Don't thank me for playing it. Thank you for creating such a magical and beautiful, underrated indie gem that will blow the minds out of anybody who plays it. Even if you're not a fan of Metroidvanias, you can beat this game without touching a lot of the extra content. So go out, get Hollow Knight, and I will catch you in the next adventure. Thank you, everybody, for watching. My name is Penta Hybrid, and I will catch you later.